What's up, Coilers? Welcome back to Coil Labs, where we do crazy stuff that you definitely should not try yourself. Especially not this one. Now, you've probably seen that aluminum doesn't seem to respond to magnets. That means aluminum doesn't interact with magnetic fields, right? Wrong. It absolutely does. You just need stronger magnetic fields. Say, like you'd get from dumping 10 megawatts of power through this coil in the fraction of a second. Using insane amounts of power, you can crush cans using magnetic fields. So how does it work? Well, before I get to that, I need to say that what I'm about to show here is extremely dangerous, and you absolutely should not try to do this yourself. This video is for educational purposes only, and is done by an experienced high-voltage professional. That being said, this is actually really simple. All I do is charge up these big high-voltage capacitors, and then short them out across this coil which is wrapped around the can. This results in a huge pulse of current going through the coil. It only lasts a few microseconds, but it creates a really strong magnetic field for that period of time. Enough that the aluminum can literally gets crushed by the magnetic field. How much magnetic field? I don't know, like a lot. I charge up these capacitors to about 2000 volts, and then I short them across these copper wires. I measured the resistance across all the wires through the coil to be about 0.4 ohms. So 2000 volts divided by 0.4 ohms is 5000 amps. It's only for a few microseconds until the capacitors are discharged, but that is a ridiculous amount of current. To charge up the capacitors, I first step the mains voltage down just a little bit with the variac. This is because if I rectified the output from the microwave oven transformers directly, it'd be a little bit too high for what these capacitors are rated for. Anyway, so then that goes into the microwave oven transformer, which then goes through this high voltage diode to get rectified. Then it goes through this current limiting resistor so that it's not like a dead short as soon as I turn it on and start charging. Then the voltage builds up in the capacitors. Then when they're up to charge, I short them out across the coil with this little switch I made. And
bruh.
If you had even bigger capacitors and can discharge even more energy through it, you could probably rip the can straight in half. I've seen other people do this, but they have way bigger capacitor banks than I have. I wish I could afford something like that, but I just don't have the money. Yet. Well, Coilers, that is absolutely the most dangerous thing I have ever done on this channel, and I am dead serious that you should never, ever attempt to try that yourself. The voltages combined with the amount of current available there is way more than enough to kill you. That's probably enough to kill a f***ing elephant or something. So please don't try this, just leave it to me. Stay safe and don't electrocute yourself. If you want to see some other stupid stuff with high voltage electricity that you definitely shouldn't try yourself, go take a look at this video.